I want you to come out now and see Bronco Billy. Quickest draw, fastest shot, quickest hombre this side of the Pecos.
Six 30 next Saturday, Clint Eastwood in Bronco Billy. Wartime, undercover operations. Hello, headquarters of the OSS at 92 Grosvenor Street.
Could be he's collaborating, or it could be he's being coerced. Either way, you'll have to bring him out.
I recommend you send the order now.
Secret missions masterminded by the OSS from 92 Grosvenor Street. A major new film at 8:15 next Sunday on LWT.
This number, 387-1919. Remember, you never know when you might need it.
Have a happy Christmas on LWT.
Happy Christmas!
Good evening. I'm afraid this evening we're without our usual studio lighting because of the industrial dispute, and we apologise for the poor picture quality. Now, the LWT headlines. A Crown Court judge is being prosecuted for alleged curb crawling. A London magistrate has granted a police summons against 49-year-old recorder Colin Hart Leverton, QC, who has twice stood for Parliament as a Liberal candidate. He's charged under a section of the 1985 Sexual Offences Act that deals specifically with the soliciting of women by men in cars. Mr. Hart Leverton has chambers in King's Bench Walk, Temple. A second man will appear in court on Monday in connection with the discovery of two nail bombs at Chelsea Barracks last month. 25-year-old Patrick Joseph McLaughlin from Londonderry will face Lambeth magistrates charged with conspiracy to cause an explosion. Another man, Peter O'Loughlin of Kilburn, has already appeared in court on a similar charge. Around 1,000 Britons are stranded in Germany, unable to return home for Christmas because the London-based Miracle Bus Company has been let down by its German partner. The service runs from Acton Bus Garage by coach to Southend Airport, and the German government say there's no licence for the last leg of the journey, by coach from Ostend to Frankfurt, so the whole operation has ceased. An unemployed man accused of attempting to murder a 20-year-old London policeman has been remanded in custody at Marylebone Court. 26-year-old Windsor Orgill of the Jubilee Court Hotel Paddington is charged with trying to kill Constable Andrew Tomlinson in nearby Porchester Gardens. The officer, who suffered a stab wound in the back, is expected to be discharged from hospital before Christmas. A policeman at Ruislip has saved the life of a baby boy who was choking on his tongue. Constable Gary Harris gave aid when distressed father Andrew Bevan came into the police station carrying baby Mark, who was having convulsions in his arms. The officer cleared the child's airways and got him breathing again, and the one-year-old boy was then rushed to hospital. And finally, a heartbroken dog owner in North London says he's prepared to walk the streets for days searching for his lost pet rather than spend Christmas alone. Richard Verscoyle of Dollis Hill has issued 500 posters of his red setter, Sasha. He's written to every vet in the capital and put up a £500 reward for the person who finds the dog. That's the local news tonight. We'll be back with more tomorrow afternoon. Now, our final programme, Night Thoughts, with Viscount Tonypandy.
Tonight, I invite you to consider the impact Christ has made upon the world. By proclaiming the fatherhood of God, Jesus explicitly asserts the brotherhood of man. His teaching gave new dignity and importance to the poor, to the underprivileged, to the handicapped, and to the old and infirm. For the first time, ordinary people were exalted to the same level of importance as the powerful and the mighty. Two commandments take precedence over everything else in Christ's teaching. First, that we should love God with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our strength. The second commandment is that we should love our neighbors as ourselves. Christ's teaching was the first declaration of human rights that the world has ever heard. Study the history of mankind, and you will find that human rights were respected first and most effectively in those lands where Christ's teaching was most effective. In our own land, we owe the very shape of our society to people whose life has been inspired by Christ's teaching. God speaks to the world through dedicated people. Christ came into the world to show us the nature of God, but also to show us what we can become when we put all our faith in God. Without Christ, our society would soon degenerate into selfishness. That is the road to self-destruction. Putting others before self is Christ's way. It is also the way to happiness and social security. Good night, and God bless you.
Now, a last look at the weather forecast for tomorrow. Sunday will be mild and quite windy, and the overnight rain will start to die out around midday. The afternoon will then be mostly dry, but still generally cloudy, and afternoon temperatures will reach around 11 degrees Celsius, 52 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's tomorrow's weather. And although the weather for Sunday isn't very inspiring, programmes here on LWT are a very different story. Looking ahead to the evening, at 7.15, Michael Aspel hosts a special all-star Christmas edition of Child's Play, in which the celebrity panel that includes Janet Brown, Roy Castle, Bobby Davro and Sandra Dickinson puzzle over a collection of words with a distinctly festive flavour defined for them by the kids. In Me and My Girl at 7.55, there's more comedy when Simon finds that he's unexpectedly got himself engaged. And then at 8.20, Cilla Black and her special guests celebrate Christmas with a special seasonal edition of the hit show Surprise, Surprise. Then at 9.35, following the ITN news, Patricia Hodge, Robert Hardy, Nigel Havers and Phyllis Calvert head a star-studded cast in a moving drama, The Death of the Heart. Portia, a 16-year-old orphan, goes to live with her stepbrother and his wife in their elegant London home. After a nomadic European childhood, the change of circumstances is traumatic enough until things are complicated yet further by the arrival of Eddie, a charming young philanderer. Comedy and drama, tomorrow on LWT. Now, we've come to the end of another evening, but if you feel like more company, don't forget that the two independent local radio stations, LBC and Capital, will remain on the air throughout the night. TVAM starts up at 6.55 in the morning, and we're back from 9.25. So, until then, with the time at 20 to 1, this is Ruth Anders, on behalf of everyone at LWT, wishing you a very restful night. Good night. And finally, please don't forget to turn off your television set. Good night.